No parent ever really gets over the loss of a child. It's a constant struggle for Holly and Patrick Wright. They lost their 5-year-old daughter, Peyton, to brain cancer in 2007. But they've managed to turn their loss into hope, helping thousands of families whose kids are going through cancer treatments. Patrick and Holly are here with us today, as well as Michaelisrael, performance artist. We'll get to you in just a second. But thank you all for being here, first of all,
thank you.
Good morning.
Thanks for having us.
So if they look familiar, that's because you two were featured as our hometown heroes in 2014 about your foundation. For those of viewers who missed that, how could you? Tell us about the foundation and talk to us about Peyton, whoever wants to go first.
We started the foundation after we lost our 5-year-old daughter, Peyton, to brain cancer, and we financially assist families caring for children with brain cancer. So we do that by paying their rent, their mortgage, their utilities, their day-to-day bills so that they could focus on their child's care. We're a national organization. We travel all over to meet with the hospitals and just form that relationship so that we can help them and make sure that these parents, you know, keep their heads above water.
And she passed away in 2007, and pretty soon after, within the next year, you had already come up with this idea and this foundation. Has it helped you heal?
It has. I think it's twofold. You know, it helps you heal, but then you can't get away from it as well, which is a hard part. I mean, we put a lot of emotional equity into it, as I say a lot, and it's good and bad. You know, it really is. It does help us heal, but you know, we deal with kids with brain cancer every day, but in the long run, I think it absolutely has helped us.
I think it's taking something positive out of something horrific and really trying to do something good and giving back for everybody that helped us while we were going through it.
Yeah, and not just people here in the Bay Area, but people across the country.
Yes.
And
yes.
Something like you said, as small as giving them gas to get to and from the hospital. I know parking is expensive at hospitals, whatever they need. You were telling me that sometimes families can't pay their rent because they're paying their hospital bills.
A lot of time I will get, and it's usually like 4:45 from hospitals all over the country, someone's getting evicted, their electricity's been turned off, so I'm the one that's documenting, sending paperwork, faxing things over, being on the phone.
Yeah.
You know, to reinstate the electricity to make sure that that person isn't get or that family isn't getting evicted.
And of course, helping people out I couldn't be done without the donations and the fundraisers.
Absolutely.
And you have a big fundraiser coming up on October 3rd.
Yes.
And Michael, you are a big part of this fundraiser.
He's our buddy.
Give us a little bit a sneak peek of who you are and what you do. And just so everyone knows, you're going to be doing an exclusive performance for us in the 9 o'clock hour. But what will you be doing at the event?
Well, I do paintings that reflect what people are feeling inside, so I just kind of bring their feelings to the forefront so they kind of know the right thing to do.
And not just, we're showing one of your paintings right now, and it's a performance that you...
Well, it's a rock concert with paint.
It's a rock concert with paint.
Absolutely.
So thank you, of course, on behalf of the Peyton Wright Foundation for lending your services and your expertise to them and for coming on our show this morning. So I just want folks to know, coming up at 9:45, Michael is going to hang around, and he is going to put on quite a performance for us. And it's all in advance of the big gala that's coming up in October, so stick around for that. We introduced you to him in the last hour. Michaelisrael is back with us. Thank you so much. You're going to do a special performance, an exclusive one for Good Day, and you'll be painting to the song Ronin by Taylor Swift?
Yes.
Okay,
yes.
Take it away.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I remember you barefeet down the hallway. I remember your little laugh. Race cars on the kitchen floor, plastic dinosaurs. I love you to the moon and back. I remember your blue eyes looking into mine. Like we had our own secret club. I remember you dancing before bedtime, then jumping on me, waking me up. I can still feel you hold my hand, little man. And even the moment I knew you fought it hard like an army guy, remember I leaned in and whispered to you, you were my best for years. turned to crying and